There's gotta be a way. For every door, there's gotta be a key, right? For every question, there's gotta be an answer. For every ham, there's gotta be an egg.
Stop already. You're wearing out the carpet.
Who's worried about the carpet? My top client, Hernando Kelly, is threatening to leave me.
Carpets ain't cheap nowadays.
A regular iron-bound contract ain't good enough for Mr. Kelly. He's got to have the same contract Peter Sands drew up for Lance Meredith.
So what's so hot about the Meredith contract?
So what's so hot about the Meredith contract? I'll tell you what's so hot. It's only the talk of show business, that's all. Every big star on Broadway wants the same contract that Meredith got.
Well, then draw one up.
Benny, what, are you stupid or something? I don't know what's in it. I gotta get a copy of it.
Look. Why don't you call up Susie McNamara, explain the situation, and throw yourself on her mercy?
You know, Ben, for a grown-up man, you really amaze me.
Is that so?
Yeah, you should be in a garden.
In a garden?
Yeah, a kindergarten, where they grow kids. You talk like a dope. You expect me to call Foxy McNamara and explain the situation to her? You know what she'd say to me? You know what her exact words would be?
What?
She wouldn't say nothing, that's what she'd say. She'd laugh in my face. Hey, wait a minute. I got an idea. Where's that book?
What book? We haven't got a book.
That book that was in a desk when I bought it from the junk dealer. Oh, here it is. You see that?
What kind of a book is that?
That's a book on physicology. It tells you how to get the best of people without them knowing it. It says here in this book that the best way to get something that you want from somebody is not to let them know what you really want. You ask them for something else.
Why?
Why? Because it throws them off the track. That's why. You understand?
No.
Watch the old master go to work. The help of this sweet little book. I'll have that Meredith contract over here within an hour. Miss McNamara, please. Benny, this book can even outfox even such a fox like little Foxy McNamara. Foxy? Hiya, baby. Yeah, this is your bosom pal, Mickey Calhoun. Yeah, now, wait a minute, Foxy. Before you hang up on me, hear me out.
I'll hear you out. The further off, the better.
Foxy, sweetheart, I'm in a kind of a jam. My client, one of my clients, insisted I draw him up a sensational contract. Now, I remember that great contract that Peter Sands drew up for Jack Howard some time ago. Yeah, I wonder if you'd let me see a copy of that.
The Jack Howard contract? Okay, you can't be serious. That contract went out with beaded curtains. You must mean the Meredith contract.
Oh, no, honey. I mean the Jack Howard contract. I heard that Meredith contract is a sensational contract, but I want the old Jack Howard contract. Yeah, you know me, Foxy. Nothing fancy, I'm just plain folk. I'm dying to keep from getting hysterical. She's falling for it like a charm. Why, you send it right over? Oh, I love you, Foxy. You're a living doll. Right. It's in the bag. That Meredith contract will be in my hands before you can say Triborough Bridge backwards.
Sands.
I don't think so. Look at that. I weighed myself this morning.
It says you are popular, cheerful, and intelligent.
I don't mean that. Look at my weight.
Your weight? 181 pounds.
11 pounds overweight.
Well, that's not so bad.
Not so bad. I'm fat. I'm losing my shape.
Oh, I think you look very well.
I am fat.
You are also popular, cheerful, and intelligent, which is the main thing.
I am popular, cheerful, intelligent, and fat.
All right, so go on a diet.
I'm going to do better than that. Exercise. That's the answer. What have you got there?
The Jack Howard contract. Cagey Calhoun called one to borrow it.
What does he want that old thing for? Why don't you send him the Meredith contract?
I don't know. He specifically asked for this one.
Idiot. Don't put any calls through for a while. I want to do some push-ups.
Well, you have to sign some papers before you run around the park.
It's all a known how, Benny boy. I told you it never fails. How do you like that for action? Get that Kelly on the phone. I want to let him know what a smart agent he's got. Hey, wait a minute. Hold everything.
What's the matter?
That stupid Foxy sent me to Jack Howard's contract.
That's what she asked for, wasn't it?
But according to the book, she was supposed to send me to Meredith contract on account I pretend I didn't want it.
Well, it could be Susie didn't read this book, you know.
I like that. Now what am I going to do?
Look, why don't you just call Susie up and ask her for the Meredith contract?
I suppose you think she'll just give it to me just like that, huh? I suppose Macy's tells Gimbel's, huh?
I don't know, but I heard Sachs tells Orbach's.
Oh, you're so funny. Well, there's only one thing I can do. I've got to go up to Foxy's office, on some pretext or another, get her out of the office and find a contract myself.
Now, just what pretext or another are you going to ask her?
It's very simple. I go up to return the Jack Howard contract, and I express to her my deep ingratitude.
I'll buy that. But you just crumbled it up.
So what are you worried about? What are you, playing with kids? Yeah? Clever, huh? Aren't you glad I didn't hock it? I told you, someday it'll come in handy. In a minute, this will be as good as new. Here, you better wrap up those flowers. Now, listen to me closely, Benny boy. I need your complete harmonious cooperation to swing this little double cross. Now, when I go up to Foxy's office, here's what I want you to do.
Yes, uh-huh. And I'd also like a case of sugarless non-caloric soft drinks. Right? And a few boxes of pound-off wafers. Mm-hmm. And then send me some of those diet crackers, you know, that look like dog biscuits. No, I don't want dog biscuits. They look like dog biscuits. That's right. Fine. Thank you. Yes, bye.
Cagey here.
Cagey? Here?
Well, lock all the silverware and send them in.
Foxy, baby.
Cagey, I'm very busy, so stick the knife in, twist it, and let's get it over with.
Not this time. This time, strictly on the up and up, Foxy.
Oh, now I am worried.
Ah, for you, Mon Cherry.
Oh. Still robbing trash cans.
Now, why do you want to say things like that for, Foxy? After all, what I ever do to you?
You want a quick rundown?
Yeah, I mean lately.
Oh, you mean the last 15 minutes?
Yes.
Well, let's face it, Cagey. You and I were meant for each other.
Yeah.
Each other's throats, that is. Now that we've got it in the open, what can I do for you?
I just come up here to return this contract in person, Foxy, and to express my extreme ramifications for being so sweet, and let me take a gander at it.
Oh, well, thank you. It's been laundered.
No extra charge.
That's very nice of you to bring the contract back so soon, Cagey. And since you insist there's no ulterior motive to your visit, I'm sure you wouldn't mind running along.
Oh, I'm in no hurry, Foxy.
Yes, but I've got a lot of work to do.
Ah, come on. I thought I'd hang around maybe a little bit, chew the fat, you know what I mean?
And go through the papers of my desk.
I did 75 push-ups. Hello, Cagey.
Hiya, Sandoval.
Miserable, thank you.
Oh, well, Mr. Sands is having a little trouble with his weight today.
Oh, his weight, huh? Well, you happen to be talking to the right man, because I, too, have fought the battle of the bulge.
Yeah?
I'll show you how to check that middle-aged spread. May I be permitted?
Oh, by all means.
Thank you.
Who are you calling? I don't want any doctors. I'll fight this thing myself.
No doctors, no medicine. In no time at all, you'll have a figure as svelte as mine.
Well, maybe Mr. Sands doesn't want a figure as svelte as yours.
Maybe.
Hello, Feldman's Jim? Hey, this is Mickey Calhoun. Yeah, I want you to do me a little favor. There's a very good pal of mine who's getting a little pleasingly plump around the old, yeah, Peter Sands. Yeah, international artist. Yeah.
He knows me?
Never heard of you. I want you to send up some barbells and a jumping rope, and let's see, one of them vibrating ponies. Yeah. Yeah, get him over here real quick, huh? Right. Nothing to it.
Oh, that's very nice of you, Cagey.
too nice.
Oh, come on, Foxy. I'm a changed man. When are you going to believe that?
When you're behind bars, and I don't mean the bars that you're usually behind.
Susie, I'm going to walk around a while. Do me good.
No, Mr. Sand.
Yeah, nothing like a good walk. When you get tired, trot a little bit.
Yeah, keep that in mind.
Yeah, take your time. Don't rush.
You seemed in an awful hurry to get rid of him.
Get rid of Sands? Don't be absurd. I'm crazy about him. He's a gentleman and a scholar.
Well, what would you know about either?
Always ribbing me, ain't you, Foxy?
No, I ain't. And what are you doing at my files?
I was just admiring how nice and neat you keep them. If there's one thing I admire, it's a neat, orderly mind.
And somebody else's confidential files?
Susie, I... Oh, I don't know what to tell him. I don't even understand him.
Who?
The man on the phone. I know it's urgent, but he's talking in one of those foreign languages like French, you know. Well, I don't speak French.
Well, who does he want to talk to?
Well, he keeps asking for a Monsieur Sands. I suppose he means Mr. Sands. It's so hard to know what someone wants when he wants it in French.
Yes, I know. Well, I'll take it here.
Foxy, would you mind using the phone in Sands' office? I'd like to make a call.
Oh, but I want to...
I promised my ancient mother I'd call her.
Oh, well, as long as it's your mother. Tell him I'll be right on.
I'll tell him, but he won't understand.
Mais monsieur, je ne comprends pas.
Ouvrez la fenêtre.
Ouvrez la fenêtre. Open the window? Ouvrez la fenêtre. Pourquoi? Monsieur, you're asking me how long the train stops here. Are you sure you have the right number?
Oh.
Oh, no, monsieur, I think you better call the French consul to help you. I don't think I can. Pardon me, monsieur, there seems to be a fire in my office.
A fire? Is Cagey hurt?
Cagey? No, not yet, but he's going to be.
Help! Help! Help!
She came in and started to holler fire. I think you got some faulty wires in there, Foxy.
There are no wires in this file.
Well, the fires can start from different regions. Maybe candles. Maybe you got
there
some...
There are no candles in this file.
Susie, what's going on
here?
Oh,
we just had a fire.
Fire? Where?
In the filing cabinet.
I think I ought to be going. It's getting a little warm in here.
Yes, you better go before it gets really hot in here.
Well, let's have some order around here.
Yes, sir.
Susie, do you notice anything?
No, sir.
Well, look. Have I lost any weight?
Oh, yes, sir. You're a shadow of your former self. I'd hardly know you.
Very funny. I'll be running around my office if anybody wants me.
Don't run. Trot.
Oh, Susie.
I could kill him. I could kill that Cagey Calhoun.
Yeah, sure, Hernando. Look, Hernando, will you please leave it to me? No, I haven't got the Meredith contract yet, but almost. I promise you, by this afternoon, I'll have it. Yes, now stop worrying about it, will you? You're right. How do you like that guy? If it wasn't for me, he'd be working. The bum, a good day's work would kill him.
What about the contract?
To tell you the truth, Benny, I don't know. To think that I had that contract in my hot little hands, and then I had to go and set the joint on fire.
Listen, Mickey. Maybe Susie's got a heart, so why don't you...
Benny, don't ever talk to me and start a sentence with Foxy's gotta have a heart. Because automatically it don't make no sense. Now get this through your two heads, will you please? Foxy's got a brain. Foxy's got a liver. Foxy's got a stomach. But believe me, kid, Foxy ain't got no heart. And I got the scars to prove it.
Look, all I was trying to do was be possible.
Wait a minute. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe Foxy does got a heart. Because she had a look in her eyes today when I asked her to let me call my little old mother.
You know, it could be that maybe she has a mother complex.
You know something? Maybe if I had my little old mother go up there and pay her a visit this afternoon.
But your mother's working in Vegas.
I repeat, if my little sweet old mother would go up there this afternoon and pay her a visit, that's it.
One, two, three, four.
Mr. Sands, don't you think you should look over four, this butler letter? One, you may want to insert this paragraph again.
Four.
Mr. Sands' office. Oh, hello, Cagey.
Foxy, dear. I hate to keep asking you, honey, but I got a tremendous favor to ask you. You heard me speak of my dear little old ancient mother? Yeah. Well, she's in town, you know, and I'd like her to come up and see the office of a successful type agent so she can see what her little boy will be like when he grows up. Yeah. I wonder if she could come up there and visit you this afternoon.
Well, I don't know, Cagey. I'd have to ask Mr. Sands. Just a moment. It's Cagey. He wants to know if his ancient mother can come up here and visit us this afternoon.
His mother? Now, what do you suppose he's after?
I don't know, but whatever it is, he didn't get it when he was here before. So he's sending his mother after it.
Well, tell him, okay, and let's find out once and for all.
Cagey, Mr. Sands says he'd be delighted to receive your ancient mother this afternoon. And please tell her to come unarmed.
I'd know you anywhere. You must be Susan.
You must be Mrs. Calhoun.
Cagey's ancient mother.
Oh, I would have known you anywhere. You look exactly like Cagey.
I'm so happy you think so.
You are? I thought you'd hit me. Oh, never mind. Now, please come and sit down. You must be very tired being so ancient and all that.
I'm just pooped. My, what a sweet office you have here.
Well, thank you. Did you just get into town?
This morning.
Oh. Well, why didn't Cagey come with you?
Well, you see, Cagey has a very important meeting to attend. And I said to him, I said, son, that's short for Sonny. I said, son, you just go right ahead. I'll manage somehow. I don't like to interfere with his making a buck.
I do. Oh, please come in and meet Mr. Sands. I know he's going to get a big kick out of you.
Oh, by all means.
My, you are a big one, aren't you? Come along.
Well, if it isn't Charlie's aunt.
No, it's Cagey's mother.
I'm certainly delighted to know you, Mr. Sands.
I'm so terribly sorry.
Yes, well, Mr. Sands was just doing some reducing exercises on this wonderful equipment your son was nice enough to send up to him.
Cagey is such a sweet boy.
Oh, yes, he is. Susie, maybe Mother would like to look around the office a little bit.
Well, she certainly would.
Oh, would you like me to show you?
No, you two just go ahead about your business, and I'll just sort of browse around by myself.
Oh, well, I think that's a lovely idea. There's probably lots that you'd like to look at in there.
Oh, you bet there is. Now, you two just go right ahead and pay no attention to me. Oh, you're sweet.
No, and I hope I never do again.
Do you think we ought to let him wander around by himself?
Well, that's the only way we're going to find out what he's looking for. Come on, I think we'd better peek.
I ever laid my eyes on. Well, I think I'll be going now.
Oh, so soon? Yeah. I thought the parole board didn't close until 5.
I have so many...
It's been wonderful having you, Mother.
Well, thank you, Mr. Sands.
Yes, and you must thank your son for this wonderful equipment.
I certainly will.
We have just one problem, though.
Oh?
Yes, we don't quite know how to work this mechanical pony.
Why, there's nothing to it, really.
Really? Well, would you mind showing us?
Oh, I'd be delighted.
Oh, how nice. Just, now, isn't that sweet of Mother?
Now, you just stand back and I'll show you. Now, you just put your little foot into the thing there. Now, stand back. Here we go. And then you turn on the little switch. The switch, where is that little devil?
Right here, Casey. Now hold on, darling. Mother is going for a little ride. Well, he must have it on him. I'll shake it off of him.
Now, wait a minute. Foxy! Foxy! Come on! Foxy! Come here, will you? Foxy! 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 Foxy!
There he is.
Come on, Foxy! Foxy! Will you stop it?
What kind of way is that to treat an ancient old lady?
Or an old phony. What's on this film?
Give me that.
I will not. What did you photograph in my office?
Oh, if you gotta know, I had to get a copy of that Meredith contract. It was a matter of life or death.
The Meredith contract? You mean you got yourself all dolled up in that rig for the Meredith contract? And practically burnt down the building?
I told you it was life or death.
Oh, for Pete's sake, why didn't you ask me for it?
Well, why didn't you just ask for it? I suppose you'd just give it to me just like that, huh?
Oh. Come here.
Be easy.
Oh, give me a hand, Father.
Now, here, we had no intention of ever keeping it a secret. And next time you want something, just ask for it. Don't come up here disguised as Whistler's mother.
Gee, Foxy, I'm much obliged to you. I'll always remember you.
Yeah. Every Mother's Day.
Yeah. I'll see you, Foxy.
Yeah, well, don't call me. I'll call you.
Susie! Susie, come here quick!